Okay, what do you think of my film? It's mind-blowing, right? What? Rude. Hello, filmmakers. Ash here, and welcome to Film It Yourself. You finished your film and you're excited to start submitting to film festivals, but slow down there, Speed Racer, because there's some important steps you should do first. So let's go over some tips to know before submitting to film festivals. First up, before submitting to any film festival, ask trusted friends, family, and peers to watch your film and give you feedback. While receiving feedback might not always be fun, it's a key part of the filmmaking process. After all, big-time Hollywood films do this in the form of focus groups and test screenings. You see, as the filmmaker, you've spent hundreds of hours working on your film, and thus you've probably lost some objectivity. Getting some fresh perspective from people who have not been involved in the film will help you fix issues before submitting to film festivals. Also, while you're still potentially in the editing room, consider the five and dime festival rule. You see, most film festival programmers will only watch the first 5 minutes and last 10 minutes of feature films, as well as the first and last 2 minutes of short films. This is because they have so many films to go through. So, make sure the beginning and end of your film is the best it can possibly be. And before we move out of the editing room, make sure you have a stellar sound mix. Your film might sound great on your computer's built-in speakers, but in an actual movie theater, every bad scrap of sound will be exposed. So, make sure you get rid of all that bad audio hiss. I said get rid of it. That's better. Take the time to hire a good sound mixer and review their mix on good speakers. At the very least, you want a stereo mix, but if possible, I recommend getting a 5.1 surround mix as well, as some festivals might require that. And pro tip, always submit a completed film, never a rough cut. Festival directors will not look past rough cuts, and you will end up being rejected based on finishing standards. One more final step before we exit the editing room. Make sure you cut a trailer for your film. Trailers are your film's first impression to festival directors, so make sure it's eye-catching and attention-grabbing. Plus, having a trailer helps promote your film, and oftentimes film festivals will use it on their website or in their social media posts. And pro tip, make a trailer even for short films. Trailers are important because they are a key piece of marketing both for you and film festivals. Even if your film is a micro short, make at least a short teaser trailer that film festival attendees can see and get excited about. Okay, you're probably thinking you're ready to submit, but hold your horses there, partner. Because first, you have to make an electronic press kit. An electronic press kit, or EPK for short, is a pamphlet or PDF that has all the information about your film. It should include your film's poster, a synopsis and logline of your film, key cast and crew bios, contact details, a full list of credits, technical specs, and finally, promotional stills from the film. This is also an opportunity to be eye-catching and match the overall vibe of your film. So make sure the graphic design is great. Okay, your film is finished, your EPK looks fabulous, and you've got a sizzling trailer. You're finally ready to submit to film festivals. But hold the phone there, because first you've got to make a Film Freeway account. FilmFreeway.com has become the main way to submit to film festivals, ever since Without a Box went out of business in 2019. RIP, little buddy. Once you've set up a Film Freeway account, make sure you make a new project for your film. This will be the main source of information for festivals you submit to, so you want to fill it out with as much information as you can. You'll want to make sure you have included a screener for your finished film, your movie poster, information about and from the director, promotional stills, and links to your film's social media accounts and website. Also, don't forget to fill in the credit and specifications information, as this will be needed by the festival as well. And pro tip, make sure all your film specs, like its total runtime, are accurate, as the film festival will depend on this information when making a decision. Trust me, if your film ends up actually being even a few minutes longer, they are not going to be happy about it. And speaking of total runtime, as an artist, you might not like to hear this, but there's actually optimal programmable runtimes. As a storyteller myself, I totally get that you might want to make your film whatever length best fits the story, but this can really hurt you when submitting to film festivals. You see, film festivals usually work in hour blocks for short films, and they depend on specific lengths for features. Thus, the optimal length for a short is anything under 20 minutes. However, keep in mind the shorter your film, the better. For example, if your film is 20 minutes long, it might be harder to program, as there might be four other 5-minute shorts that are just as good, and thus the festival director might choose those instead. When it comes to features, you want to make sure your film is between 60 minutes and 2 hours in length, because anything over 2 hours will be harder for festivals to program. And while we're talking about length, let's talk about your credits. First, as indie filmmakers, it might be tempting to credit yourself for every little thing you did, but at the end of the day, that actually looks amateur and bloats your credits. And second, you want to make sure you keep your credits short. You see, the shorter your credits can be, the better, especially with short films that are playing in a block one right after another. So consider not having opening credits. However, if you must have them, make them play during the film instead of before. Next, keep your ending credits as short as possible. If you need to, create a film festival-only version of your credits that are short and sweet. Then use the longer version for the final release of your film. And remember, only credit yourself for the main roles you fulfilled. After all, no one cares if you did the crafty. And pro tip here, keep your ending credits interesting. Sometimes during short film blocks, audience members can get restless and leave during credits. So find ways to keep them engaged by showing behind the scenes photos or continuing to tell the story in some way. For example, for my short film Zombie Debt, the producer and I hired an After Effects artist to make a stylized ending credit sequence that continued to build out the world of the film. So, you know, get creative. So, now that you know these tips, your film is ready to rock the film festival circuit. And for more tips on film festival stuff, check out my playlist here. Okay, so I addressed all of your notes. What do you think now? Is it better or worse? You're useless.